I told you guys Invincible gets stupidly good. I told you guys it gets amazing. Once you get to the Viltrumite War, anybody who's read Invincible will tell you that. Once you get to the Viltrumite War, everything changes and the show just becomes insanely awesome, right? Viltrumite War Part 2. So in the last video, we had this whole situation where Mark and his dad and everybody, they had all basically left Earth, right? For the purpose of meeting up with the Coalition of Worlds and essentially preparing for the start of the Viltrumite War. And that's one of the funny things, right? Is that we almost kind of imagine war starting with like somebody walks onto a field and blows a whistle and the war begins, right? Instead, it usually just starts with something popping off, right? Archduke Ferdinand's driver takes a wrong turn down the wrong road. Princeps waiting for him, his failed assassination attempt turns into a successful assassination attempt, and World War I begins. It's always something like that, right? It's always some kind of situation along those lines. And this, again, is where it all starts to kick off, that you've got Mark, you've got his brother Oliver, and then you've got a Galdarian. Now, here's a funny thing. The Galdarian is basically the Invincible stand-in for the Galadorian Space Knights from Marvel Comics. For those of you guys who don't know what they are, you ever heard of a character named Rom the Space Knight? It's fine if you didn't. Rom hasn't been relevant in 20 years, but that's basically what it is, right? Just people who, in effect, at least in Marvel Comics basically, had their minds, consciousness transferred into a robotic body, and then they serve as, like, you know, soldiers more or less protecting the universe as best they can, and usually failing in the process. So this is essentially a ragtag bunch, and Conquest doesn't take these guys the slightest bit serious. The only one he really seems to have any concern about here is basically Mark, because he and Mark fought before, and Mark kind of started to get the upper hand, or at least demonstrated the fact that he is pretty capable when it comes to facing against Conquest. The biggest issue here is that when it comes to these guys, right, these Viltrumites, that whenever they sustain an injury, when they heal, they're stronger than they were when they first sustained the injury in the first place, right? They just kind of grow stronger as time goes on. Now, again, all that kind of has to do with age. They don't really progress at the same rate as somebody like Alan the Alien does, right? Like, he gets a lot stronger, a lot faster than Viltrumites do, hence the reason why he caught up with them in terms of strength so incredibly quickly. But Viltrumites do get stronger as they're injured and as they recover and as they grow older with age. And so Mark is kind of a credible threat here, but not enough for them to really panic. Instead, it's one of these things where literally Conquest's whole stance is, I'm gonna save you for last. Instead, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kill everybody else here, and then I'm gonna kill you. I want you to watch as I kill everybody that you know and care about here in this particular location. And then once I'm done with you, then I'm gonna go back to Earth, and then I'm gonna take care of Earth, right? It's a kill order on Mark. That's basically what it is, that the Viltrumite Empire is not taking any chances. And it makes perfect sense, right? That one of the things that was solidified in the previous videos that we talked about is that there is a kind of perfect connection between the human race and Viltrumites. And that because of that, there is almost this ideology that when a child is born as a product of a Viltrumite and a human, that they're actually stronger than Viltrumites or possess the potential to become stronger than a Viltrumite at a much faster rate. And so it's one of these things where it's like, just get rid of the world, right? Get rid of Earth. I mean, ideally we would turn it into a planet where we would basically turn into a breeding ground, but assuming we can't do that, just nullify it, knock it out of the way, and then we'll continue conscripting whatever races exist across the universe and keep our empire alive that way, right? It's getting rid of any major and incredible threats that exist there. The funny thing about this is that this is payback time for Mark as well as for Nolan. And the reason why is, of course, Nolan and Conquest have met previously, but as soon as Nolan shows up, Conquest immediately gets the upper hand on Nolan and kind of just like headbutts the heck out of him and basically knocks him unconscious for a brief moment. And then Mark steps back in again. And that's kind of the funny thing here is, even though you've got two other Viltrumites going, you know, in this major conflict, you've really got it coming down to Mark and Nolan, Mark and his dad versus Conquest. And like, Mark's pulling out all the stops on this guy. But at the moment, the kind of conflict that these guys offer, Alan the Alien, along with this basically a space knight more or less, they don't really offer a whole lot, right? I mean, there's not a whole lot they can do. I mean, Alan can do a lot more than pretty much anybody else, almost including Mark, but it's 3-on-3 at the moment. And really two of them are normally facing off or really facing off against one of the Viltrumites. So the numbers are heavily stacked against Alan and them. And so face off as they might and do as they can, one of the big questions that Mark has while he's fighting Conquest is, how did you get free? And that right there is a limitation of Mark. That's the important thing to understand here. And again, going back to the early story arcs, right? The early stories we did when Nolan was still on Earth, when Nolan fought Mark, teaching him how to fight as they were fighting in that kind of climactic battle between the two, Mark struggles with distractions. The reality is that in this moment right now, it doesn't matter how Conquest got out. It doesn't matter how Conquest got away. What matters is stopping him. Now, if stopping stopping him allows him to live long enough to spill the beans on how he survived. That's cool. But at the moment, he's an immediate threat, right? A clear and present danger to everybody here and the people on Earth. So the only thing to do is to put this guy down. But ultimately, Mark's distractions get the better of him to a degree, and that ultimately you end up having Conquest who kind of spills the beans a bit and says, like, you know, I have no idea how I lived, right? Obviously, you didn't beat me to death, and I just kind of woke up underground on your planet's surface in some giant containment unit by somebody who was foolish enough to think they could hold me, right? Right off the bat, Mark realizes that it was Cecil, right? He's like, okay, so Cecil kept this guy alive. That's kind of the crazy thing, is because he's like, would I see him again? And then Conquest kind of chimes in and says, why would you be so foolish to think that you'd be able to see anybody else again? But once you have Mark basically, you know, holding his own against Conquest, Nolan deviates and then starts facing off against the other Viltrumites. The numbers are even, then they start to sway into the favor of Nolan and Mark and Alan the Alien and so on. And it's a cool thing here, because as that happens, the question that's really posed here to these Viltrumites is, why would you face off against us with only three of you, right? Like, I, Alan the Alien, am stronger than you guys, you know, just barely, but I'm stronger than you guys, and we've got Nolan, and we've got Mark, and we've got Oliver, right? Like, we've got the upper hand on you guys. Like, what would make you guys believe you could somehow come out on top here? In the middle of all that, here come one of the conscripted races. And that's really the meat and potatoes of what makes the Viltrumite Empire so incredibly strong here, is that it's not just the fact that there's 50 Viltrumites left, and they're super powerful, and each of them are easily capable of conquering the world. Instead, it's that they conscript other races to do bidding for them. And that's what really allows them to maintain such a strong hold over the universe. That and the fact that nobody knows there's only 50 of them left, right? If the rest of the universe found that out, they would marshal all their forces and it would literally be everybody against the Viltrumite. But instead, using a combination of allowing the universe to believe that the Viltrumite race is this massive race of people who live on this world, that it allows them to kind of conquer worlds and then force races into their service and then go forward accordingly. And that's what you get here, right? You know, energy beams firing down and all kinds of crazy stuff going on and so on. But in the middle of all that, Oliver, as the younger member, right, the youngest person here, hasn't quite mastered the ability to hold his breath as long as everybody else. And so he starts to suffocate. And so he's given an instruction and just saying, go, right? Just take off to that world down there and just like grab a breath for yourself, catch your breath, come back, everything will be cool. And then Conquest chases after him. This is when Mark becomes one of the most brutal versions of himself, right? When Mark just completely lets go, because he knows definitively that if Conquest catches up to Oliver, he's gonna kill him, right? I mean, this is just remorseless murder. That's exactly what it's gonna be, right? So Oliver flying down to this world, trying to catch his breath, Conquest chasing after him, Mark chasing after Conquest, and like leaving everybody behind, right? And so ultimately, of course, Oliver gets back down to this world, catches his breath, and then before Conquest can get to him, Mark gets to Conquest, right? And that's the crazy thing. That's what's so wild, is because Mark knocks the wind out of him and is like, oh wow, you know, so like you were coming to this planet so you could breathe, weren't you? With the wind knocked out of him, he immediately starts to choke him, right? Like the air's been knocked out of his lungs, so he can't even breathe at the moment, right? So Mark just starts choking him and starts holding on for dear life, right? Like you end up having like Conquest who tries to fly out of the world. It's not doing him any good. He's doing everything he can to get Mark off of him. And it's crazy, because while all that's going on, Nolan's like, where's Mark? Where's Oliver? Where's Conquest? Where are they all at? And like everybody's like, we don't know. And so Nolan immediately like abandons everything, right? With just reckless abandon, goes directly after Mark, goes down to that planet's surface trying to find his son. The whole time, Mark's got his arms, like his hands, just around Conquest's neck. And this is the nature of what it means to be a Viltrumite, right? The whole time this is happening, to have this level of fortitude, this level of desire to truly just eliminate a person. While Mark is holding on for dear life, Conquest is just crushing this guy, right? Just pummeling him as best as he possibly can, cracking ribs, right? The whole nine yards. I mean, Mark is just being tattered, but the entire time, he doesn't let go, right? He says, like, I'm not letting go. Like, I'm never going to let go. Holding on to him, like strangling this guy for dear life. Literally, it even gets to the point where Conquest punches a hole through Mark, right? Like, rips a hole through him. His bones are protruding out of his back, right? Like, you're talking about like compound fractures, right? Like, rib bones are protruding through his back, and Mark won't let go. Just keeps strangling and holding on to this guy as long as he possibly can. Even to the point that, like, Conquest reaches into like this gaping wound in Mark's stomach and pulls his guts out, right? Like rips his guts right out. Like Mark doesn't let go. And ultimately, Conquest is killed. And this is what it means to be a Viltrumite, to have this level of strength, this level of durability. Notice, this is what it took for Mark to kill the guy. He couldn't beat him to death, right? He couldn't like pummel this guy to death. He couldn't punch his head off his shoulders. He couldn't smash his skull in, right? I mean, I guess he could have done that before, but the guy healed. So obviously it wasn't enough. What he did before didn't work. He had to just cut this guy's oxygen supply, right? Just cut this guy's ability to breathe. And Mark, guts strewn all over the place. Nolan shows up, Oliver shows up, and the only thing Mark can do is just yell for help. With that being said, guys, we're gonna bring this to an end. Cliffhangers. Thank you guys for watching, and I will catch you all later. Peace.